back of the textbook, because people have asked me about the, myself, the author. So I say my significance is all connected with the system of racism, which is white supremacy. And so my very existence is in that system. And I was born into the system. There's only one system of government on the planet, and that is the system of racism, as applies to me. And so I am subject to that government 24 hours a day, wherever I may be on the planet, in all areas of activity, economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war. War meaning any type of conflict in which people are harmed, bodily harm, mentally harm, property is destroyed, etc. So the system of racism governs all of this in my individual and existence, and in all of my connections with other individuals. And according to what I have observed and what I wrote about in the textbook for victims of white supremacy, is that all people classified as non-white are dominated by this particular system. So that means if there is a system that should not be, and certainly a system that's designed to dominate and mistreat people, that should not be. And this royal system called racism, which is nothing but basically a royalist system, is based on being royal based on color. And some people are classified as being royal, and other people are classified as being non-royal. And people of color are non-royal. They're not members of the universal or the planetary royal family. You have to be white to be that, classified as white and treated as white. There are a lot of non-white people who look like they're white, but they are not classified as white and not treated as white, so they are not members of the royal family either, because the white supremacists determine who is going to be in what they call the white establishment and what we might call the white race, which is the only race. Sometimes people say there's a human race. That's a contradiction. You couldn't be human and be racing against other humans. That, you know, what kind of context do you put that in? I mean, if you either practicing humanity or being humane to people, or you're not. Being humane means what? Using that word that this program starts off with. First of all, being a person that practices justice. Now, justice cannot be practiced in a system of white supremacy. You can only do your best to practice it on a day-to-day basis as an individual, because you're already a prisoner of war. You're a prisoner of a war in which you are in captivity, and so far we have been losing that war. The war is not lost until you stop fighting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So people of color have not lost the war until they just give up altogether and say, well, just do what you want to. We're not going to fight it anymore. It's too exhausting. But most, either directly or indirectly, most of the non-white people try to resist. However, most of the time, very feebly, do we try to resist this system that is in place, rock solid in place. The world's business is based on mistreating people of color in the form of this thing called white supremacy that somebody dreamed up a long time ago, and it turned out to be the most efficient system and the most powerful system for mistreating people ever thought up in the minds of people on this planet. So no major problem that exists, getting back to what is on the back of the book, the textbook for victims of white supremacy. The second statement in that is that no major problem that exists between the people of the known universe can be eliminated until racism, mm-hmm. which is white supremacy,
yes.
is eliminated. You can't solve any problem in any area of activity. I don't care what you do. It's going to turn out to be a mess. The way everything is right now in 2018, if you don't consider solving the problem of conflict based on color, the color of people's skin, in trying to solve that problem. Now, anyone who will observe it or study it or try to practice it, try to just go about doing whatever they're going to do, they're going to run into that color issue. One way or another, directly or indirectly, white or non-white, you're going to have to deal with it. And so people usually just deal with it by saying, well, it's there, and it's in place, and nobody knows how to solve it. Nobody's figured out how to do it yet, and they're correct about that. So it's just something you have to live with. And then other people say, not so. I don't believe that. I believe it should be eliminated and replaced with something called justice, which means guaranteeing that no person is mistreated and guaranteeing that the person that needs help the most gets the most constructive help. But in answer to the question, can justice be practiced in the system of white supremacy? The answer is no. That's impossible. Based on what? Based on logic. You can't have a system that is committed to non-justice and then think that you can have justice in a system that is set up to produce non-justice.
Okay.
It doesn't compute.